tube, multi-double M68 here. I consider myself a budget gun consumer. I try to look for guns that are priced under $400. So, you know, I carefully choose what I buy. You know, I shop around and try to look for good deals. I think, like many middle-class Americans, we want to get a good value for our money. And after about several years of really wanting to get this pistol I'm about to review, I've been able to purchase it. And let me go ahead and show you what I got. This is the Smith & Wesson M&P9 Compact. 9mm. Came with two magazines. 10 rounds each magazine. I recently purchased this pistol. I got it around early September. I got it from Bud's Gun Shop, BGS. And I really got an awesome deal on this pistol. I mean, I've been wanting this pistol for like the longest time, but it was always out of my price range. But thankfully, this past summer, 2017, there was just a lot of awesome deals going on in the gun market, and this pistol was part of that deal. I got this pistol for $379. And really, it's a pistol that I've always wanted for the longest time. It's, like I said, M&P9 compact. I would say it's comparable to the Glock 26. Lengthwise, it's about 6.7 inches in length, and height is 4.5 inches. Glock is, I believe, measuring at about 6.41 inches, so it's not as long. Actually, this has a 3.5 inch barrel versus the Glock's 3.4 inch barrel, so it is slightly longer. It's actually considerably heavier than the Glock 26. This gun right now, I believe, roughly weighs about, with the magazine included, and I'm talking about this flat base magazine that's in here, it roughly weighs about 24, just over 24 ounces, I think like 24.2 ounces. Glock 26, with its magazine, comes around weighing around 21.7 ounces, so this is considerably a little heavier, about 2.5 ounces heavier. But nevertheless, personally, I consider this my baby Glock. It's a really nice pistol. It has nice 3-dot sights. It does have a chamber indicator for your rounds. It does come with 3 back straps. I think I got here the medium-sized back strap. And these can be interchanged, but basically remove the magazine, turn this little knob here, you can pull out this rod, and if you wanted to, you can go ahead and switch out, put a different size grip. I got the medium size placed in here. For my big hands, it's not a bad pistol. Even though I don't have my pinky's underneath here, with the flat blade plate, it's really nice. You do get a magazine with a pinky rest or a pinky extension here. That's also 10 rounds. I know this also comes on some models. It comes with a 12 round magazine. But what really drew me to this pistol is that, like the Glocks, especially the Glock 26, you have magazines that are interchangeable. And that's, you know, like for example, for the Glock 26, you can use a Glock 19 or a Glock 17 magazine inserted here. And honestly, I didn't realize that you could do that with this pistol. I thought, well, you know, you just stuck with whatever magazines they give you. But no. And here I have a M&P9 full-size 17-round mag. Excuse that it's loaded. I do have it, you know, ready for use for self-protection. But, you know, first of all, I'm going to show you it's an empty chamber here, so you won't accuse me of being irresponsible. And this is a 17-round mag. You can insert it in here. Boom. You got 17 rounds. And I know there's like a 30-plus round magazine available out there. From what I've been able to find, they're mostly made by Pro Mag. But I'm pretty sure there's a Smith & Wesson type magazine available. Or a magazine made exactly by Mrs. Smith & Wesson. So I just need to search around a little more. Also, for a 17-round mag, you can get these little grip extensions here. This one I got, I think they call them X-Grips, but this isn't an X-Grip. It's made by another company. I think it's called Amerigun.com. But it basically serves the same purpose. It's considerably inexpensive than the X-Grips. X-Grips run around $12-$13. This one I got on eBay for, I think, $7. And it works perfectly. You basically insert it here, and you can put it here. You got to be careful. Don't have your pinky in between here, because you can't pinch your skin. I found that the hard way. But with that grip extension there, oh man, this just feels really, really nice. Other features of this pistol, does have a slide release. It is interchangeable. It is a smooth action release. It allows the magazine basically to pop out pretty good. It's got nice slide serrations here in the rear. Has your standard M&P type M&P type trigger. It is a bit gritty, like a lot of these M&Ps are. It's a you can feel the grittiness here. But another thing, and it's probably a negative, is that this does have a magazine safety. So if you have a round chambered and you don't have the magazine installed, it won't fire that chambered round for this particular pistol. You got to have the magazine inserted to fire it. It is gritty trigger. I rate the trigger roughly between 6 and 7 pounds. It's not too bad, actually. You do get to that point where you do get the resistance on the trigger, and then there's a nice crisp break. Boom. And your round's discharged. And then reset. It's hard to hear on this pistol. You can't really hear it, but yeah, just barely. But it goes about basically back to where it stops, and then you can pull the trigger again. Boom. Nice crisp break. I normally don't like to disassemble my pistols in my reviews, but in this case, it does have a bit of a challenge to disassemble this pistol. So basically what you do is you rack your slide, lock the slide here, you turn this little knob here to the side. Now once you do that, if you look carefully, and here let me provide a bit of a background, there is that little metal piece here sticking out in the center. It's I don't know if you can see it. It's a real thin metal. There's another piece there, but it's not. It's right dead center in the It's that metal, thin metal piece there. Anyway, what you gotta do is you gotta depress that. And once you depress that, you gotta hold it and then release the slide. Well, release the slide, put your finger in there, press that metal piece there. Boom, that causes your slide to eject off. Your standard insides of your M&P, you got the guide rod, the spring, nothing new. And then you just put it back on. Knob goes back to its original place. It's just that issue with this assembly, but aside from that, overall it's just a really nice shooting pistol. In the beginning of my video, you saw my shooting profile of this pistol, and the first shots I hit center mass, I used this flat-based plate here, this flat-based magazine to shoot off my rounds, and I was shooting a little left, and I think that's my fault, but eventually, with time, I was able to improve my where I was placing my shots. The headshots, I was using the 18 round magazine, and that was also going a little left for me. But again, that's my fault with the trigger. I guess I was just pulling it a bit to the left. But otherwise, it was still, in my opinion, a bit accurate. In fact, if you can hold on a second, I'll get my target. Here's the center area here, and measuring, it's a pretty good group size here. It's about 3 inches, pretty much. Got all 10 shots here using the 10 round mag with the flat base plate. And then you go up to the head area, where using the 18 round magazine, which really pretty much, you know, shot flawlessly. It's about a 5-inch group, with the exception of an outlier here. About 5-inch group right around here. It's not bad at all. And like I said, I was shooting a little left, but that's my fault. I was just pulling it a bit to the left. One thing I want to point out, I did do a review for a video where I was critical of a Walther CCP that I used to own. I went ahead and sold it. I was having a lot of issues with the limp wristing. Although I don't think I was limp wristing, I think it's just an issue with the pistol where it's just very sensitive how you hold it, I guess. And especially firing it one-handed, it kept having failure to feed issues. So what I started doing too, if you look at this group here, I also use the again the 10 round flat base magazine, and I was shooting one-handed. This is from 7 yards, and I was shooting one-handed, and I didn't have any kind of issue with limp wristing or anything like that. And you know, I got this little nice group here, you know, width-wise, roughly about 5 inches, you know, 3 inches, 3x5 group, which is, you know, not bad for one-handed shooting. I think it's important that, you know, from now on, at least when I test out a pistol or my, you know, a pistol that I purchase, it's always important to, you know, see what it shoots like one-handed. I think that's important because, you know, you never know. I mean, I've seen videos where people say, well, you know, you may not be able to shoot two-handed. You know, in some cases, or, you know, in a lot of these real-life cases, there are people shooting one-handed. And I think so it's important to develop that skill set of shooting one-handed. I think if you develop that, I mean, you know, you become just really skilled at that. And, you know, you work on your mindset too. But anyway, that's another topic. As far as my method of carry, I've always mentioned that I like to carry either pocket carry or fanny pack. And, you know, you saw my fanny pack. You can fit this quite well inside this particular fanny pack. And as far as pocket carry, as long as I think you use the flat base plate, which I did recently on an outing, you know, to the movies. You know, I do have a license to carry, so I did use this UTG pocket holster, and it fits quite well. I was wearing cargo shorts, and they're a bit baggy, and even though it is a rather heavy pistol, and especially when you have your rounds in there, it is heavy, but, you know, I had a tight belt around my shorts, and so it kept my pants up. But it didn't really feel uncomfortable. I didn't feel any kind of discomfort, you know. So that's another way to go. But of course, you can do the other methods of inside and outside the waistbands, which is fine, you know. And I have nothing against those type of carrying devices. I just prefer pocket carry or fanny pack. That's just my thing. I know. You know, being a budget guy, I mean, I was just really fortunate to get this pistol. I mean, it was a pistol that I really wanted for, like, the longest time, maybe about 5 or 6 years ago. And, of course, it was just out of my price range. Right now, again, this pistol went back up in price. I think right now they're selling that about $475 at Bud's Gun Shop. And, you know, but fortunately, I was able to get it this summer at that really nice price, and really, I'm just really happy. I'm happy with the shooting profile of this pistol and the accuracy. It's not bad. I've probably put in about 125, maybe 130 rounds of 115 grain ammo. Normally, I use Blazer Brass. I've also used American Eagle, and, you know, inexpensive Federal round nose rounds, and cycles perfectly. It's just a really nice pistol. This is basically my baby Glock here. My hope is to maybe with time I'll buy some more, maybe some more 17 round mags, and maybe some more grip extensions. And I mean, this is just really, really nice. It's a really nice pistol. And I got it really at a nice price, and I'm just really happy. I mean, to really want something and to finally get it, it just makes things really nice. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video, and y'all take care, and God bless.